And I'm outside because of you. So
I like the natural light.
So, introduce us and where are you?
Okay, I'm Mondz. I'm based in Sydney, Australia.
Welcome. What time
right
is it?
Right now the time is 4:20 p.m. on Sunday afternoon.
17,000 hours ahead of me.
I know. I can't keep up with it. Thanks to Google. Every time I have to Google to check what time is it somewhere else.
Okay. Are you guys under lockdown?
Nope, we're not under lockdown, but we are under restrictions.
Okay.
So it's not a lockdown, but there are restrictions.
So
then like there has to
curfew?
Yeah, go. Not a few.
Okay.
Not a few, but there has to be a certain number of people in public transport. Mask is mandatory. If you don't wear a mask, you get fined $200.
Okay.
Yep. Every shopping center, they're like hand sanitizers.
Everywhere.
You can't have a certain number of people at your place. For instance, if you are having dinner currently, if you are hosting dinner, it can only be 5 people. That is if the family is not
made up of five people already.
So for instance, in my family, we are already 5. That means we cannot host. Even a single person, we cannot.
I can't come over for dinner? Damn.
No, unfortunately not. Now that there's a limited number of people that should attend weddings and funerals.
Mm-hmm.
So
mm-hmm.
All this happened around Christmas.
What happened on Christmas?
So just before Christmas, like around the 20th, the 19th, there was an outbreak in one suburb, which was brought up by one American pilot. So here in Australia, when people come in, if you can't visit me,
mm-hmm.
you'll get quarantined at the hotel. You go under mandatory quarantine.
Okay.
When you get off the airport, they get you into your bus and they take you to the hotel.
Doesn't matter if you come in with a negative test or not.
It doesn't matter. We're not interested in your test.
Quarantine.
You arrived. Yes. Which makes sense because you tested wherever you are, but you got through the airports.
Multiple.
And the plane. Exactly. So we don't know what you picked up while at the airports. So whether you're negative or not, even if you can say, I tested this morning, we don't care. You go to mandatory quarantine at the hotel for 14 days. This quarantine at the hotel, don't get fooled by a hotel. You don't open the door. You don't open the window. Even if your friend is in the next door, you cannot go and hang out. Like you stay in a hotel room for 14 days.
Proper isolation.
Yep. You only open the door when the meals come. When they bring the meals, they drop them at the door and they knock and they go. You open the door, pick up your meals.
This is like a fancy prison, really, honestly. Like, at least in prison, you can see the guard give you the food, you know?
That's what I call it. But I'm so glad they did that. I worked, they started the hotel quarantine in March when this thing started, like, outbreaking.
Yeah, immediately.
So initially, people were asked to isolate at home. But you know people, they'll be at home and they'll be like, oh, my kids need to go to the park. Let me take them to the park. And then the next thing, it was just going crazy. They're like, okay, fine. No more home isolation, mandatory hotel quarantine.
Damn. Okay, so what are the numbers if this thing had to be mandated?
So the numbers now, it's really working well. Trust me, I cannot emphasize that enough. It's just that, like, it's expensive, but it's worth it.
The hotel mandated quarantines, are they all over Australia or just in Sydney?
No, all over.
Oh, okay.
So since you asked me about the numbers.
Yes.
So since March, these are the numbers from March to yesterday, the 16th. Right?
Sure.
So since March there've been 28,689 positive tests.
That is so little.
Wait. And then 909 deaths.
That is so little, guys.
The current active cases. Current active cases, 227. And now, coming to the positive tests from yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
19 tested positive from the hotels.
Mm-hmm.
But this one is not a concern because they're contained. Mm-hmm. So when they test positive at the hotel, they get taken from there. Also the hospital hotels,
right,
which are for people who tested positive.
All right.
So when they test positive, when they do the testing, now I can't remember it very well. I worked there for the first 3 months,
mm-hmm.
but the first day when you arrive, maybe the second day you arrive today, the second day you get tested, and then you'll get tested again on your 10th day, and then you'll get tested again on your 12th day, or the 13th day, yes.
Yeah,
you get tested again on the 13th day. So when you test positive, whether it's 13th or 2nd or 10th, whenever, when you get tested positive, they remove you from that hotel. They take you to the hospital hotel, which are hotels for positive people, and mm-hmm. you'll stay there until you're clear.
Do they treat you while you're there?
If you need treatment, yes, they treat you. Before we get to that one, let me now blow your mind off with the locally transmitted cases from yesterday. It's just one, all over Australia, just one.
What?
Locally.
You guys are doing the most.
Acquired. Yes.
One.
So this one, all over Australia.
No, that's.
And the test, I didn't pull that one out. The test, this one will be out of 22,000 tests. Like they test.
All the time.
All the time and everywhere, like everywhere that testing station, and it's free.
Oh yeah, that's what I wanted to know. Do they have testing stations or do they come to people?
Testing stations everywhere, and it's drive-through. So you just go there, you don't get out of your car. They test you, you drive through.
That is so dope. That is so dope.
Yep. And when you, let's say you have, so when you have any mild symptoms, I have sinuses myself. I get bothered by sinuses. I sit next to someone with a strong perfume. I get sinuses.
Irritated.
I can't even wear perfume myself.
Oh, shame. So, okay.
Yep. So if I'm sneezing
mm-hmm.
and I know it's sinuses, like as mild as that, I can't even go to the gym because it's COVID symptoms. Even if it's hay fever, you know it's hay fever.
Yes.
You don't go anywhere, you stay at home. Kids, when they're back at school, my son has sinuses a lot. He eats an ice cream, he sneezes. He has missed school so much because he had blocked nose and he had to stay at home.
What are they doing at the schools? How are they making sure the kids are not being super spreaders?
When the kids get to school with those mild symptoms, they send them back. And they should get tested.
Damn.
And they should bring back the results to school.
Okay. So, are they segregating the kids at school, the number of kids in a class? What's happening with that?
So what they do now, like the drop-offs, they are like, there's no just one time for drop-off, like usually. So it's like at certain time, it's this class, certain time, the other class, certain time, the other class, the same as pickup.
Okay.
The same as pickup, so that kids don't cluster together. And again, we have to, like, as people, we need to understand that we are in the middle of pandemic. Things should not be done normally. It's everything that's against what you normally do, but you should understand that we are in the middle of pandemic. Things should be done differently. Otherwise, we are all in trouble. You're asking about the restaurant. The restaurant, when we first got in, they have the scan. Oh, I wish I took a picture of that. They have a scan where you scan on your phone. It's a mm-hmm. barcode.
Mm-hmm.
You scan on your phone that barcode. That's a check-in. That shows that you've checked in there at that place.
All right.
If ever it happens that someone who was there. So this check-in, when you check in there,
mm-hmm.
the Minister of Health get that stats. So I check in there, I leave my number and my details. If today I don't feel well, I get tested, I test positive, they notify the place that someone who was there between such and such time, because you check out as well when you leave, between such and such time tested positive. And then everyone else who was there within that time will get a notification.
Yes.
In the restaurant, there's a COVID-safe patron, something like that, someone wearing that thing, making sure that everything is as it should be. The tables are cleaned properly.
The distance between you and the next table?
Yes, distance. The tables are in such a way that they should be the distance that should be. Yeah.
Okay, that's cool. Do they have a capacity limitation as to how many people can be in a restaurant?
Yes, they do. It depends on the size of the restaurant, because the tables have to be, people have to be certain square meters apart.
Mm-hmm.
I can't remember. Yes, yeah, so depending on the size of the restaurant.
Okay, yeah. Cool. So what home remedies are you guys taking, if there are any that are popular over there?
Surprisingly, none. The home remedy that you are using here is staying at home. And I'm telling you, that's the home remedy that works wonders.
Okay, so it's because most people are quarantined at a hotel. So I don't know. But you worked there, so you would be privy to some of this. What are they taking if they are positive in the hotel, being isolated?
It's just like vitamin C, the same thing you take when you have cold.
Basically, the flu concoctions and
the
stuff.
The flu concoctions. But when their symptoms get worse, that's when they're taken to the hospitals, the proper hospitals. They get checked out by the medical staff. So I worked at a normal quarantine hotel, not the hospital hotels.
Yeah. Okay.
So at the normal one, we assumed everyone who comes in is positive. That's why we're not going to their rooms. We're just talking to them over the phone. If you're unwell, we're like, what are the symptoms? And the doctor assesses you over the phone. And then gives a prescription and writes the prescription. The prescription is sent to the pharmacy and the pharmacy delivers the medication to the hotel.
Okay. Do you remember when Oprah started to have doctors on her show and how people would go to the doctors and say, when I Googled on the internet, this is what WebMD said I had and stuff. And Oprah and everybody would discourage us from self-diagnosing and checking on the internet. And now we're having telephonic consultations, guys.
Oh, yes, we do.
Wow.
Now things have changed. Everything has changed now.
And the thing that needs to change more than anything, I believe, is us, our behavior.
Yes.
So, vaccine, what are your thoughts? Are you guys going to take, what's happening in Australia with the vaccine? What are the talks of the vaccine over there?
The Australian, generally, before we get to the COVID vaccine, Australia is very strict with vaccination. Your kid cannot go to school if they're not well vaccinated. Amongst other things, when you go to register your school, it's the vaccination report.
Okay, so it's not like America where you can choose if you believe in it or not.
You can choose if you vaccinate your child or not, but
if you don't,
yes.
What schools do they go to, get the ones that believe they don't believe in vaccinating?
I think they do homeschooling, because there's also homeschooling. There are parents who do homeschooling and Yeah, so I think they homeschool their kids. The vaccination, they're making sure that when they get the vaccination in Australia, it will be effective. So there was another one that was tested here, and then they canceled the order because it gave the false HIV test positive. So they canceled it.
That is bizarre.
I know. So they're very strict with that. So by the time they roll it out, which you don't know yet, they'll have checked that it's safe. What I know is for people to travel, at least here in Australia, they won't allow you to travel here if you don't have COVID vaccine. That's what I know. And that's where they're going to catch me.
Yeah, because you like to travel.
Exactly. So.
Oh my God. I can't.
And Yeah, and that's so sweet. And right now, even the state borders are closed. So in Christmas, when we had that spike around Christmas, where the restrictions were tightened because of the one pilot who was positive, unfortunately, from the US, went to a coffee shop in one suburb, and then we had a lot of cases. There was a lockdown in that suburb. People had to cancel their plans. Like people who had planned to go interstate for Christmas holidays, they had to cancel because the borders were immediately closed.
Did they have cops there at those borders or something? How?
Yes.
Oh, yes. They did the thing.
There were people who got busted. They went to Gold Coast, which is beautiful. It's in a different state.
I've
they
seen.
Were from New South Wales.
Yeah.
Yep, they got busted. And they were fined for $4,000, something crazy.
But then, like, okay, so here they are writing my ticket. And then, so what if I don't pay it? What are they, how does this work?
You can't hide. You can't hide.
Is everything documented on a system and they will find
everything.
So what's been the, maybe the biggest change for you with this COVID? What's been the one thing that you saw and you were like, wow, okay, it's cool that we're doing that. Or that is really weird that we're doing that for you.
The biggest change that I'm really enjoying and looking forward to enjoying it even post-COVID is working from home. Now with COVID, we've learned something.
Right?
That I can
we can.
South Africa for holiday and still work. I don't have to take a leave because I'm on vacation.
It's fantastic,
that's something,
isn't it?
I'm taking you. That was my aha moment that was brought by COVID.
I saw your workstation and I was like, girl, you are set up. I was like,
It has to be set up because I review, like, I'll be working with data, reviewing documents. And so I have to open like multiple documents. So even if I'm working from home, it had to be like that.